know that so many times it gets overwhelming to see all of the new releases coming out in makeup, and everybody seems to be trying the new. And we do want new stuff in our life. We like the new, the pretty, the innovative, but you might already have some really great gems in your stash. And that's what I did. I shopped my stash for hidden gems that I haven't talked about for a very long time on my channel. Usually talk about these at least once or twice, and I, you know, then you get caught up in what's new and what you're trying to review for you guys. But I found 10 that I think are really, really good, and we're gonna talk about those today. Hi, my friends, and welcome back. I'm excited because this video isn't about go out and purchase a bunch of new stuff. It's what you got already in your stash. And it really has helped me to look at some things that I not necessarily have never talked about, because I have usually talked about everything on my channel if it's good and if it's still here. So what I want to do is revisit some of those things that I think are really good. Some of them I may have talked about 3 to 6 months ago. Maybe it's even longer. I don't remember when I talk about things, but it seems like I've not talked about these for a long time. So we're going to start out with Hard Candy. I love Hard Candy's primers. They have some next level primers. They're really, really good. But this one from them, which is called the Sheer Envy Pore Defense Primer, this is a really good primer. And I like it because it doesn't have any silicone in it and it doesn't have any oils in it. And so it just does the trick of helping to blur those pores and making a barrier between your moisturizer and your foundation, so your foundation doesn't get sucked in during the day and worn off. And it really does a great job without all the extra things that a lot of other primers do. It is 12-hour pore refining, minimizes the appearance of pores, pore defense primer. I like it so much. It is on the back of it. It says it's a lightweight primer serum, helps tighten pores instantly. Astringent, helps absorb excess oil for flawless makeup wear. Comes out a little bit greenish, a little bit watery. It really does feel like, as you're just, you know, rubbing it in, that it just immediately sinks in and that your pores look so diffused. I love this stuff, and I wanted to make sure that I talked about it again. Everything will be listed and linked below as usual. This one isn't necessarily drugstore per se, as far as you can run out and buy it at the drugstore. And when I talk about drugstore, I'm kind of talking about a price point. I think that there are fantastic things in K Beauty and J Beauty that you can find that are that drugstore price point. So this is one of them. This is called from Zing Beauty, and this is the blush and bronzer, and it is in Bloom. And this is so pretty. This is very much like all of the other stick ones that are coming out. Jouer had one come out recently. I think Anastasia may have even released one very recently. I love this color of pink. You guys know I'm a pink person, but that can be really, really sheared out, or it can be really built up. Now, the bronzer is a little bit different because it's pretty light, but it's a pretty bronzer on. One thing that I make sure that I do, it comes with these little caps. I make sure that I put those little caps back on each time because it keeps it fresher. So, like I said, you're going to be able to sheer it out to where it's just a wash of color if you want it to be. Keep it bright if you want it to be. And same thing on the bronzer. You can sheer that out. It really won't build up much darker than that, but I love it. I think that it's one of those ones that a mature woman can wear so well because it is a cream product, and the fact that it blends so well. It's so easy to blend. It doesn't set down too quickly, so you know you have patchy or anything like that. Plus, being a cream product, it really hugs the cheeks after it sets in. So this is one of my favorites. Now, along the blush line, I have two that I had completely forgotten about. I do have this one on today. I did show this in a video yesterday. So this is the L'Oreal True Match Blush. And let me find what color this is in. I want to say it's C something, C5 and 6. And these blushes are so pretty. They are just silky and nice, and you're able to build them up. And I, of course, choose pink like I always do. This one feels like to me like it has a tiny bit of a sheen in it. L'Oreal does have such good blushes and such good makeup, and this is one that I have loved for a long time. Beautiful color. And then the Rimmel Maxi Blush. This is another one that I had forgotten about, and I'm like, I need to pull that out. Okay, this one's called Third Base. These, I just remember being ones that really, really hugged the cheeks and stayed on all day. I remember that I really liked this color too because it's more of a peachy color, so it would go with just about anything. It's one of those ones that's kind of peachy pink. Almost, it's that blend. So this is more of a really pink with the L'Oreal, and then this one's a peachy pink. But I remember this because it was so silky and it goes on your skin and it just glides across your skin. But I do remember that I liked its staying power as compared to a lot of blushes. And sometimes at that end of the day, I look at my skin and I'm like, how do I even have any blush on? So it's nice to have a blush that you feel like will hug your cheeks and stay on all day. Product that I completely forgot about, and I don't even know how I forgot about this, but this is the Catrice Under Eye Primer. I talked about this so much on my channel for years, and then it just kind of, again, got pushed to the back, and I've been just using whatever primer I use on my face to go up underneath my eyes, but this is a super dose of hydration to go underneath your eyes. It's clear. It is a really nice level of hydration. So if you have super dry under eyes, you're going to like this. It's just that boost right before you put on your foundation or your concealer, whatever you choose to put on underneath your eyes at, you know, to conceal your darkness. It's a great boost underneath there. And I had completely forgotten about it. I used to do this every single time. I would do this, then my color corrector, then my concealer. And it worked so well because, you know, dry, crepey under eyes as you age is just ages you when you look at makeup. So this is definitely one. It's actually called the Catrice Liquid Camouflage Under Eye Primer. And it's definitely one that I had forgotten about, but I absolutely love. Another thing that I had completely forgotten about, and I actually don't even know if I talked about this on my channel or not yet, but this was in the back of the drawer. I think these are absolutely wonderful. This is from Maybelline. This is called Color Strike, and it says cream to powder shadow pen. Okay, so what it is that the powder is down in this part, and this little part right here is just a little like sponge tip applicator. You just tap that in there and then you can put it on wherever you like. This is perfect to do those little areas like going in. I already have a ton on, going into the inner corner, doing the brow arch, and then just kind of blending as you go. This is perfect. It's a great color. I know that they do have other colors as well, but this little color is just a little perfect brightening color, and I will see if I can figure out what color it is too. Probably not. I have terrible eyes. Oh, it's 30 Spark. It's called Spark. So every time you put it down in there and you twist it down in, it goes in and you can feel a little spring, and then you can just get the powder out, put it on your eyes. Super easy, super quick. I love this. And it does come in a bunch of different colors. So you might look at it even for, you know, just drawing on a line and then blending with your fingers of the other colors that might be a little bit deeper. Great delivery system. I think that this is really a neat product. This palette from e.l.f. I have shown this on my channel before. I've talked about it. I even think I talked about it in my 2020 favorites. But for some reason, when this gets pushed to the back of everything and then I go and I pull it out again and I use it again, I'm impressed all over again. This is the e.l.f. New Classics. This is so pretty. It has a beautiful blend of warm tones over here and cool tones over here. It has light products that you can use. I love it when they give you light colors to go across your lid, because lots of times there'll be colors that are way too dark and I can't get a good enough look at it because I'm super light, super fair. And these are so pretty. I love that it gives you these little different colors that you wouldn't think of as being nudes. Like this is kind of a golden celadon celery green color, and then you have these beautiful peaches in here. You have some that lean towards having a bit of mauve in there. They're so pretty, and this is a great formula. If you like the little bite-sized ones, you're gonna love this formula too, because it pretty much is exactly the same formula. It's just giving you a much bigger selection, and I think they're so pretty. Let me show you that green one that I was talking about, because that probably is one of my very favorite colors. It looks probably a really gold, but it does have that shift of green in it. So pretty. I really like it. I think that this is a palette that, because e.l.f. releases so much so quickly, that this palette has gotten overlooked. I like this one, and I like the Earth and Ocean one as well. I think if you have those two, you've got such a variety. But I think this is $14, and for $14, oh my goodness, and I cannot believe that this gets pushed back so many times, because I've had this for a long time, but I keep forgetting how great of a palette it is because I try so many different things. But if you're looking for a neutral palette with just a little bit of a difference that you can use without, you know, dipping into a lot of color, this is gorgeous. All right, two lipsticks that I feel like have really gotten lost lately in all the lipstick releases, the lip gloss releases. There's just always so much coming out that the good lipsticks really get forgotten. And I always talk about Maybelline on my channel. But boy, these bold matte lipsticks from Milani, these are so good. This one is in I Am Fabulous. And these colors might be really close, as a matter of fact. I've quite gotten into darker lipsticks just very recently. This one is definitely your mauve color, definitely your pink color, deepened color. I love this. I love the matte because it is not like one of those mattes that's going to dry you out, but it is a matte that's going to stay around a lot longer than a regular bullet lipstick. And these are creamy and they go across your lips and they don't feel like they've just sucked the life out of your lips during the day. I really like this. I love that formula. I hope that they're not going to be getting rid of that because I really do like that formula. Now, a formula that is a little bit more emollient is from Rimmel. And again, I forgot about these. This one is called Soft Hearted 200. And again, I think these colors are going to be pretty darn close, but I love both of them for the difference in their sheen. This one is the one that I have on today, and it is so pretty. I just kind of put it all over the exterior of my lips. It's a beautiful, very juicy, very yummy formula. It's so buttery and it makes your lips feel so hydrated. And you can tell the difference in the two. Like this is very, very, looks very saturated. Tiny bit more of maybe a little bit of rose in this one, whereas this one is a definite mauve color. But I love both of these formulas and I love both of these bullet lipsticks, and I had completely forgotten about them. And the fact that they're in the back of my drawer and I pull them out today for a summer look tells you something, because I feel like that brighter, bolder color is beautiful in the summer, but I forget about them so much. So both of those formulas, the Rimmel and the Milani, I have loved for years and years and just forgotten completely about them. And then lastly, I feel like this is a hidden gem that nobody ever talks about. I think this is one of the most versatile, best products that I probably have ever tried from NYX. This is so good. This is the NYX Multitasker Mixing Medium. This little handy tool right here will give you the ability to transform any makeup item that you have, especially powders, into a bulletproof, waterproof formula for whatever you need. So this comes out very, like just a little teeny tiny dot is all you need. I don't know if you can see that or not. It's a tiny, tiny dot. And then what you do, I'm gonna make a bigger dot, but you don't need this much. Okay, so what you do is you dip into your blush. Say you liked this blush and you wanted this blush to be a color for your lips. So really get your blush, your finger going on there. You can use a brush if you want to too. Take a little bit of that mixing medium and then go in and mix it together. And you are going to make a custom matte lip color that's going to stay on your lips all day long. And that's what I love about it. I think it's so cool. It is awesome, because what it's going to do is it's going to dry down and it's going to be bulletproof throughout the day. It's going to be so good. You will be shocked when you do this. The other thing is, if you do have one of these colors and you're noticing that during the day they kind of rub off, or you know, they fade in their color or whatever on your lid or wherever you want them to be, again, I'm just picking that up with my finger. I'm going to mix it in there with that. It's going to not only brighten it, but what it does throughout the day is it's going to make that bulletproof. That's what this does. It makes it set down so that you have that on all day long, no matter what. But anything that you want, if you want a custom eyeliner color, let's say that you needed a, I don't know, you needed a gunmetal color to be your eyeliner color, but you didn't want to use a shadow, mix it in with this mixing medium, use it with a little liner shadow brush and brush it across your bottom lashes, or, you know, even if you wanted to tight line with it, if you have a little teeny liner brush, you will get a bulletproof. Throughout the day, you will absolutely have this on. And the first time that I discovered this, I was like, whoa, that opens up endless possibilities for any palette you have. If you have a palette that you like the pinks in, you can make a custom pink lipstick and then just swipe a little gloss across there or wear it just as a matte, and you've got it just gorgeous. You have a brow color that you want to mix with it and then, you know, paint it into your brows and form your brows with it. It's going to be there at the end of the day. This little thing has lasted me for like 2, maybe 3 years. You need so very little to go such a long way. And I kid you not, this will make any custom liner you want. I really want to show you that. Okay, so let's say that you like these two colors right here, this blue and this blue, but you wanted a combination of the two together as far as a liner goes. So you wanted to mix them. So I've taken both of those colors. I've really loaded up this brush. It's going into the mixing medium. People ask me, now isn't that just the same exact thing as if you wet your brush? It's not, because this mixing medium acts like a magnet to your skin or glue to your skin, and it's not glue though, just so you know. And then you can do a custom liner, whatever you want, and that will be there. It will be there all day. And you can make custom shadows, like I said. You kind of have to work really quickly with them and be real careful, but it's very inexpensive and it can completely transform your whole makeup collection, because then you have the possibilities open to you so much. Okay, so let me show you something. Here's the one that I mixed in the beginning. That's the one right there. It's not budging. That's the lip color that I tried. And here is the one for the lid color. Again, not budging, not on my finger at all. Oh my goodness. That is budge proof. I'm gonna have to go use a cleanser to get this off of my, hand. And this one isn't quite dried down as it is. It's dried down too. And nothing on my hand, but it's not coming off of this hand. So cool. I love this stuff. All right, that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for spending a bit of your day with me. Do you have products in the back of your drawer that you keep forgetting about? Let me know that in the comment section. By the way, make sure that that brush is really cleaned out after you use it, because that will stick too. You can clean it afterwards, but it's just easier to do it a little bit before it gets dried down with that mixing medium. Thanks so much. I love you, and I will catch you all in my next video. Bye, my friends. Thank you.